Every day, 800,000 hazmat shipments are traveling our roadways. A percentage of these shipments use tank trucks. In an event one of these tank trucks rolls over, would your department be prepared to handle such an incident? Hello, and welcome to our demonstration showing you the Northwest Hazmat Tank Truck Rollover Simulator. There are many dangers associated with tank truck response. This simulator makes you safer and better prepared to deal with the real emergency when it happens. It is the only simulator like it on the market today. For the next few minutes, we're going to show you how easily this simulator works and what a valuable training tool it is. This is only a demonstration of the training simulator. No air monitoring will be taking place during the demo. On an actual emergency, air monitoring would be of the utmost importance. Let's start by describing the basic features of the simulator so you can get a better feeling for what it can do. Beginning with a simulator in the upright position, I'd like to start with the dome lid. This is an actual size dome lid found on full-size tank trucks. It has been designed to fail, something I will show you in just a few minutes. Next is the vapor recovery system with a full-sized internal valve. Later in the demonstration, I will show you how this system can fail and what you and your team can do to prevent a spill. So far, we have talked about systems that you would find on an MC-306 or 406. The next thing you will see is a 3-inch cleanout. This is something you will find on a chemical truck such as an MC-307 or 407, but not on a fuel hauler. This has been installed so you can practice with the BETS emergency offloading fixture. The next item is the manual and emergency shutoff system. When you pull the handle, you manually open the internal valve. This lets product flow through the product lines for unloading fuel. This also opens a valve as part of the vapor recovery system that allows air to enter into the tank. The last item to show you before we use the simulator is the emergency shutoff. By pulling on this, you shut off or close the internal valve and opposing vapor recovery system. To get started with the tank truck rollover simulator, we need to add water. But before we do that, make sure the simulator is on a flat surface. Adding water will also add about 800 pounds of weight to it, and it will be difficult to move once it's full. Our simulator has already been filled and is ready to simulate a rollover. As we rotate the tank, notice that the dome lid is now leaking, releasing product. This is the first thing you will see and will need to take care of. My partner here will place our patented lid-tight dome clamp on the dome housing to stop the leak. See how fast and easy that was? Make sure you're using the correct protective clothing. Once the lid-tight dome clamp is secure, you and your team can start assembling your tools to perform the offloading of the product. Remember, we are demonstrating the simulator only. In an actual rollover, air monitoring as well as grounding and bonding would need to be completed prior to any contact with the tank. This area has been installed on the tank to give you the opportunity to actually drill into the tank and transfer product. By replacing the disc, you can practice hot tapping over and over so your team becomes familiar with the process. Once the hole has been drilled, you can insert your vapor can and stinger assembly. Again, remember that air monitoring, grounding, and bonding need to be in place prior to you making any contact with the tank. Once the product has been offloaded, remove the stinger and plug the hole. Finally, cap off the vapor line and upright the simulator. Using the POTS device, we're going to contain and control the remaining product out of the vapor line into a pop-up pool or other containment device. At this point, you and your team have completed the product recovery. Now the student should remove the lid-tight dome clamp, replace the disc, and fill the simulator with water. Now the simulator is ready for more training. There are many steps to a safe recovery. The key is to practice so that the actual incident is safe and precise. This simulator lets you achieve that goal. Thank you for watching this Northwest Hazmat demonstration of our Tank Truck Rollover Simulator. For more information, to schedule training for your organization, or to order a Tank Truck Rollover Simulator, please call Northwest Hazmat at 1-800-597-1323.